scientists believe a child is born with. That's one with 11 zeros. So those of you who are writing down 11 zeros. Or that's the number of stars in the entire galaxy. But is that really important? Fine, my child is born with 100 million red brain cells. Somebody's child is born with maybe a little bit less, or somebody is born with a little bit more. Does that make my child more intelligent or less intelligent? No. Then what is it that actually determines the intelligent levels? The emotional quotient of the child. What actually gives the best start to child? The synapses, the connections between those brain cells. The connections that you make between neurons, that is what determines the intelligence level and the emotional quotient and giving the best start to a child's life, the synapses.
Great.
We now determine we have to focus on synapses.
All of you are.
Everybody synapses, how do we make them? How are we going to develop these synapses? We do it by giving children experiences. Experience-based learning. And I'll talk more in detail as my presentation goes on how we actually give children those experiences to make a rich network of pathways, of connections between the brain cells. One of the ways is you have to engage all the senses of the child. The five senses, right? You have to engage all the senses. Four different kinds of learners. Come on, tell me. What are the four different kinds of learners? One learner.
Kinesthetic
is one, yes. No, ma'am, you can't answer all. You have to answer all. Kinesthetic, visual, auditory, and readers. VAR came on. Most experts, brain experts say these are the four kinds of, although there are people who are now trying to debunk their theory, but most people generally believe that it's a VAR came on. Visual, auditory, visual, and kinesthetic. You have to engage, when I said you are teaching one child in your class, you could be visual, you could be auditory, you could be a reader, you could be a kinesthetic. Does that mean that I only learn by visual? I only learn by seeing what I see? Or I only learn by hearing? Or only by reading, or by kinesthetic, actually getting involved, getting identified, being a part of. No. No one is only one of these. It's a combination of all. But perhaps more balanced, more in favor of kinesthetic, or more in visual, more in auditory. So, you have to engage all the child's senses. How do you do that? One of the things is, this is a classroom in CISTEAM actually. It's about engaging the sight, the senses of the child. Look at the way the classroom has been designed. It looks very friendly, right? Look around you. Look at PJ paper. The way the classrooms have been designed, there's science behind it. You are engaging the visual senses of the child by the classroom you provide. I don't think any of you know this, that when we are actually designing classrooms with architects also, with the education experts out here, we talk about also what should the lux levels be like, what should the decibels levels be like, what should the acoustics of the classroom be like. What are lux levels? The lighting. What is the optimal lighting in a classroom? What is the optimal auditory, the decibel levels of a classroom? How do you reduce echo in a classroom? The new schools that we are starting, that we started in the last few years, if you notice the roof that is there, the ceiling that is there, as a specially sound absorbing room.